Friends, welcome to my program Facts, Figures and Quotes. Friends, have you heard of the Chapati Movement? Friends, the Chapati Movement was the mysterious chain of chapatis that psyched the British officials during 1857's mutiny rising, or that we call the First War of Independence, 1857. The Chapati chain must have been India's first chain letter that waged a psychological warfare on the British government way back in 1857. Chapati, an inseparable part of North India's diet, the innocent looking round chapati or roti that you call, became a dreaded weapon for many officials of the British Raj. As India was readying for the 1857 rising, mysterious chapati started circulating like today's chain mails. Nobody knew from where these chapatis emerged and where they went. Rumors started flying thick that it had hidden messages that Indians were sending from one place to another. Some believed it was part of a religious cult. Whatever be the conjecture, nobody dared break the chain, lest they become the victims of some kind of a wrath. As early as February 1857, British officers across North India in the Doab area, located between Ganga and Jamuna, reported that village chowkidars and policemen were circulating chapatis. The mystery deepened. On questioning, the men said they were equally clueless about the reason or origin of the chapatis. The first chapatis were made of flour and lotus seed, but soon the rumor fragmented and stories of circulation of lotus blooms started circulating. Moinuddin Hasan Khan, a Delhi policeman, in his book Mutiny Game, mentions the mysterious incident in 1857 while in charge of Paharganj police station. A constable asked Khan how to deal with the chapatis arriving in the villages. The modus operandi was very simple. An unknown man would run up to the village headman, hand over a chapati in haste, asking him to make five more and send it to five other villages, and with strict instructions to continue the ritual or the chain. According to Khan, people, mostly illiterate villagers, wouldn't break the chain for the fear that some ill omen will befall upon them. Author Andrew Ward chronicled the incident in his book, Our Bones Are Scattered. Ward's experiences, mainly drawn from Kanpur during 1857, says that the Brahmin viewed the chapatis as the idea of Dasa Bawa, Nana Sahib's guru, who foretold that Nana's suzerainty would one day extend as far as the chapatis reached. Yet another view of the chapatis was expressed by Colonel G.B. Mallison, who chronicled the 1857 rising. He says the chapatis were the weapon chosen by Maulvi Ahmadullah to psych the British. The Maulvi from Faizabad devised the way to show the growing discontent among Indians and the prelude to the rising. Due to rapid expansion of the chain, chapatis were arriving everywhere, but without any obvious sign or script. Chapati runners waged a psychological warfare against the British. As many as 90,000 policemen had forwarded chapatis and obtained receipts after handing over the chapatis. The Friend of India, an English newspaper published from Srirampur, reported in its March 5th, 1857 edition that British officers were left confused and equally scared when chapatis arrived in every police station in the area. The chapatis had travelled wide from Farukabad to Gurgaon, from Awadh via Rohilkhand to Delhi. In all likelihood, the chapati movement was started by a clever group who dispensed the idea of a conspiracy as they readied for the rising in advance. Whatever the origin, the guesses remained wild until date. Not even a single person knows what the purpose of the chapati was. Whatever the origin, the guesses remained wild until date. Not even a single person knows what was the purpose of the chapati. So friends, that is the power of chapati or roti. And that's all I have for today. Goodbye and see you soon.